Okay, I'm Dionysios from bikecompanyname.com. Today I will explain how you can connect your Namecheap domain to your Squarespace store. I have already signed in for my Namecheap account, but before I start with the presentation, I would like to ask you to like this video and subscribe to the channel if you enjoy the content. Okay, let's start. I go here on the top right on account section and I click domain list. I will see the list of my domains and I will choose the one that I want to connect with Squarespace. I click manage on the right. And I need to be sure that I'm using Namecheap basic DNS and not some other custom DNS, or else I will not be able to connect my Namecheap domain to my Squarespace store. I click here on up right on advanced DNS. I will get some details from Squarespace and I will add them there. First, I delete everything that is already there and I will visit Squarespace. I have already signed in here. Click on my face, account dashboard. I have already a site with a subdomain from Squarespace. Here on the left, I click settings, domains, use a domain I own. I will copy a domain, paste here, continue, connect from provider. I will choose Namecheap, connect domain, and I will get some DNS records. These are the records that I need to transfer on advanced DNS section on Namecheap. Okay, I have two CNAME records and four A records. Let's try. We will start with CNAME, host, copy that, target. This is from required data. And then we click that green tick to save changes. Let's add the second CNAME from the drop-down list. Here I will copy www as a host. We'll put it here. And as a target, I will copy that from required data. I save that too. So we have 4A records. Host will be always that symbol. IP address, this number. I save. Second A record. Different IP now from required data. I save that too. Third A record. This symbol again. The third IP data from here. We save. Oh, I actually didn't save the other two. And the last A record. I save that too. Of course, actually, I can even click that save all changes just to do a bulk save. Now, if I refresh here, maybe, oh, some records are verified already. In the worst case, this connection can take up to 72 hours. The usual case is that it will happen within 24 hours and in some cases in minutes. Maybe we are lucky here. No, I see that the connections are unstable. We can actually test the connection here. Almost over. Oh, it is actually connected. Oh, okay. That happened in some minutes, but usually it would not be so fast. Okay, that's all for me. And just be aware that this connection might be not be so fast on your side, and it is absolutely normal. Please leave a comment below if you have any question or you have any idea for a future video. Bye!